Hey guys, welcome back. In today's video, we're gonna paint this piece of glass here. I'm Toby. This channel here is all about showing you how to draw and paint. So, make sure you hit the subscribe button here not to miss any new episode. So you see, the painting was square-sized here, but I didn't like it. So I decided to cut off something, not bottom part here. Yeah, this is another palette for the grass part here. See basically the greens here and the yellowish tones for the lighter part. Some brushes here going to use, rigger brushes. Yeah, putting on the color here, very thin down, very fine. Then I grab the fan brush and yeah, put on the grayish, bluish color here. Putting it on further down the road with the rigger brush here. And of course, again the fan brush. And this is a tool you definitely need when it comes to painting grass. It saves so much time. It's really fantastic. Now I start to build up this shadowy part here. Some of the lighter tones and see that I'm basically using all different kinds of grayish tones here, yellowish tones here, greenish tones here, brownish tones. And I think this is a key to painting a realistic looking piece of grass, especially such a wild one here. You need to have all kinds of different color variations and all kinds of different shapes of the leaves of the grass pieces here, different kinds of directions and sizes. And sometimes I just paint the tip of the grass, sometimes like here the whole piece. And yeah, I think this is the key to getting in some really realistic looking grass. Getting lighter again, as you can see. Just mixing color for the next few pieces that I paint. And yeah, here I'm trying to connect the darker part left to the lighter part on the right, as you can see. Again, putting some brownish tones here to prepare this connection of the darker and lighter part. And you see, this process takes a while. If you want to have it done in a realistic way, you would just need to take your time. Here again, you see me sometimes just painting the tip of the grass. And I think this helps a lot when it comes to doing this whole thing in a realistic way. I'm grabbing some darker, very thin down, greenish color here. I'm trying to get in this transition from the darker part to the lighter part. Switching back to a bit more brownish tones here. Using the fan brush again here for the foreground part. And also getting in here darker parts, lighter parts, some nearly black color parts here, as you can see. And basically building up this connection from the darker part to the lighter part here. By putting in the colors, basically the darker tones from the left on the right side and the lighter parts, lighter colors like this one here, for example, from the right part to the putting it on to the darker part on the left. And this color here is basically the color that I used for the underpainting on the right side. Pretty light greenish and warm tone here. And again, getting in the leaves, the grass pieces, randomly, in all kinds of directions, all kinds of shapes. You should follow your reference material, but I think there comes a point where you have to leave this and start to understand what's going on your painting here. And you have to develop a sense of where to put these details in. And also where you have to put in the different colors. You see, I'm getting lighter and lighter. Building up this connection from left to the right. Again, switching back to a bit more brownish tones here. And this here is now basically the second lightest tone. Very light greenish color here. And this is, I think, the rule of thumb. You start with darker tones and build them up gradually. And then you get lighter and lighter. And the lightest tones here, I just put in the tips of the grass. And setting in some highlights here. Again, not everywhere, the whole piece of grass. Just some tips, some parts of it. And with this way of building up this whole thing, you don't have to paint every single piece of grass. You just give a hint of the grass and of the different colors that are in. And then it starts pretty soon to look realistic. And the rest of the painting is built up the same, more or less, using the fan brush. And adding in some details here, some lighter ones. And this whole thing takes a lot of time, but I think it's worth it. And in some more detail and some finishing touches here. Some leaves that are, some grass pieces that are even lighter. And again, some dots, points and all kinds of directions, and we're basically finished. If you want to learn more about how to paint grass, I got here another video.